hi everybody. Okay, I don't know how well this is going to actually come out on video because it doesn't seem to be as clear as I had wanted it to be. But I wanted to share with you something very, very special. I recently went on a little shopping excursion with my friend Kathy, and we went to our favorite store that we like to do a little bit of antiquing at, and it is the Antique Emporium in Beaver Falls. And I got some really cool treasures there, so I wanted to share them with you, and here we go. So, in this bag are all my goodies. So, I'm going to take them out one by one for you. I got a few tins, and these tins are so beautiful and perfect because I'm going to be using these in my home to house some of my teas in. And currently, I have all of my teas in a beautiful basket, which I plan on doing a video very soon of sharing with you all of my current teas that I have here at home. But most of them are just in boxes within the basket. So I'm planning on taking some of them and putting them into my tins. And I'm very excited about that. So I've always collected tins, and I thought, why not use them to house my teas? So here's the other tin that I got, and this one is really cool too. This one is very Asian inspired. I really love this one. And then I got a couple of, these are like a pewter or sterling silver little catch-alls. And this is a cute little, it almost looks like a cake stand. I just love that. And I'm planning on probably putting this up in our bedroom to kind of catch all little things like perhaps change or jewelry or things like that. And this next one is a little basket. Look at that. Isn't that adorable? So sweet. Yeah. I feel like I have something in my eye. I hate that when that happens. But anyways, so adorable. Oh, and I wanted to tell you, everything I'm showing you thus far is all from their dollar section. They have literally decided to create a section within the Emporium that everything in that area is on sale for a dollar. So that is really cool. And then I got this adorable little candle snuffer. Look at that. Isn't that sweet? So I picked up some of these items for actually Christmas gifts in mind. I don't know about you, but I think about Christmas in advance, and I'm always searching for the perfect gift that looks really, really expensive, yet doesn't cost a lot of money. And so I have somebody in mind for this beautiful little candle snuffer. It's so delicate. I just love it. And then also, wait till you see this. This is wrapped in newspaper here for protection, but oh my God. I love this. Look at this treasure. Look at this. This is the most delicate and sweet little watering can. I almost didn't pick it up, but I kept going back to it, and I thought, you know what, Dina, you know by now, you need to listen to your heart, you need to listen to your gut instinct, and do what it's telling you to do. And it spoke to me and said, you better get that, because if you don't, it won't be there again. Lord knows when you'll get back, and you better get it, because it's really amazing, and it needs to be yours. So I got it, and I just love it because I will be watering all of my little house plants with it. So it is so cute and delicate. I just love that. And then, let's see what else. Oh, I got this adorable little treasure. Look at this sweet little thing. This is a brass little compote dish. So, so adorable. And I'm really not sure what I'm going to do with this yet, but my first initial reaction for this was to use it as a little prayer and blessings bowl for my altar. And I not only have an altar in my living room that I speak about a lot, and I've showed you altar and mantle tours for that, I also have one in my kitchen, I have one in my office. I have one in my studio. I have one in the hallway and the upstairs. I have little altars all over my house. So I'm sure this will find its very own perfect spot to house a very special and personal blessing within. So I'm really excited about that. And then I got two bags filled with all kinds of lovely treasures. And everything inside these bags was a dollar for everything. So in this first bag, there's some really cool beads, which some of them are, they're already in bracelets. And I'm going to be keeping them in its own form, except for two of them. The ones that I'm going to keep in its original bracelet form are these lovelies. And individually, this is what they look like, if you can see that. It's so hard to see in this camera and in this lighting. That. This. They're so boho. I just adore them. And that. And they just look amazing. And now that I've shown them in video, I'm actually going to put them on and wear them now. Because they go with my outfit today. They're just so amazing. Oh my gosh. Love them. Love them, love them. Okay, and so, yeah, look at all this gorgeousness. Ugh! You know me and all my bracelets. Just totally love. Love. okay, and then also, this is a little children's. It looks like a little, I don't think it's sterling silver, but it's a little bangle-like bracelet. And it has lobster claw clasp in the back. And it's so cute. And Jimmy said, that's adorable. You should give that to Hunter. I think it's too small for summer, but it would probably fit my little grandson. My granddaughter's probably too big for that. My granddaughter Summer. So I think that's going to go to Hunter and hopefully it'll fit him. And then this is the other bracelet that is really, really cool, but I'm not really digging all the beads that well for me personally, but I know I'll be able to do something with them. And then these are just so gorgeous. To me, these emulate rose quartz crystals or rose quartz stones. So I'm going to take this apart and do something very special with these as well. And then this next baggie had 1, 2, 3, 4. It actually had 5 items inside it, and 4 of them were pins, and 1 is a cross. And one of the pins looked like, they're all vintage, and one of the pins looked like a very cool, almost like a 1960s type of pin that was black and white, and it almost looked like a tulip to me. So I gave that to my friend Kathy because she's attending a wedding this weekend and she will be wearing black and white, and it just matched her outfit perfectly. So the other pins were, and I specifically bought it for this one, in fact, because this is a cameo. You can see that. It's a little cameo with a design of a floral arrangement of, it looks like roses. And I have somebody very special in mind that I'm going to give this to for a Christmas gift. And then this is, it's like a leaf, a gold leaf pattern. Really cute. I'm probably going to keep this. I was thinking about reselling it, but I think I'm going to keep it because I wear hats a lot in the fall and winter, and I think it would be beautiful on a hat. And then this is gorgeous. Look at this. This is a vintage poinsettia pin. I can't wait to wear this. I have a collection of vintage Christmas pins, which maybe someday I should do a video on that. Not just my vintage Christmas pins, but all of my vintage pins collection. I think people might really be interested in that. So stay tuned for that one. I'll write that down so I don't forget. And then this right here is a really pretty silver and turquoise cross. So I was thinking I'd probably add it to a really cool chain or bead, a string of beads to go with it, and sell this one. I think it's just gorgeous. So gorgeous. So if any of you out there like, it's probably not real turquoise, but it emulates, it's faux turquoise. If any of you like crosses with turquoise and you'd like me to make you a necklace, message me, leave me a comment in the description box, comments below the description box, and we can chat a little bit about a custom cross necklace for you, or for somebody special that you know. And just a few more items that I wanted to share with you. One more from the dollar section. This is so beautiful. And this is not like a dollar store stained glass. This is actually something that would be from Hallmark. And I have somebody else in mind for this beautiful treasure. This is a gorgeous stained glass Hallmark brand hummingbird window hanger. Just gorgeous. Love it, love it, love it. And like I said, I'm probably going to keep that for a Christmas gift for somebody special in mind. And, okay, so that was all from the dollar section. Now, I paid full price for this one, but it's okay. This was only $3, and these are chopsticks. These are Asian chopsticks, and I think these are authentic Asian chopsticks. They're so beautiful. They had a pair in black, and they had a pair in white. I should have bought the black pair, so I told Kathy that if she goes back to the store and they're still there, she knows exactly where they are to pick them up for me, and I'll pay her for them later because I really like them and I should have bought them. But the reason I didn't is because I already have a pair of black chopsticks, and they're not to eat with. These are for other decorative purposes in your home, or my plan is to wear them in my hair. So I already have a pair that's, it's not Asian, but they're really cool chopsticks that I wear with wire wrapping in my hair, and I thought it would be nice to have a white pair too. So these are actually beautiful though, because they have a gorgeous pattern of an Asian landscape, and I can't wait to put my hair up in a bun and wear these in my hair. They're so gorgeous. Ugh. And then lastly, for all of my mystical friends and all of my magical friends, I got this book, and this is a postcard book of magical unicorns, and this book was only $5. They have a section down below in their basement, and all books are $5, and it's in perfect shape. I saw in the copyright that it's from the 80s, but the neat thing about this is that, and I'm never going to disassemble this book because I just love the artwork. Even though I would love to send these as a postcard to someone, I will never disassemble them. So what I might do is I might make copies and use them, the copies of the photographs of these postcards in my artwork, and then make reference to the artist. But they're just gorgeous. Each one has a different, and it's really too hard to pick up on camera, so I'm not really going to, but, you know, take your time up and show you all these individually, but they're just so, so beautiful. I mean, just look at that. Gorgeous. Just absolute gorgeousness. And then that was actually it from the Antique Emporium. But another thing that we did is we had dinner together that evening, and we stopped at the Wine and Spirit store and picked up our wine. And right in the front, when you pay at the cash register, they have all these little bottles of liquor that you can use for making, you know, a one-shot drink type of thing. And they had these adorable little mason jars. Look at these, of moonshine. And it's like an Applejack moonshine. So Kathy got one and I got one. And she actually had one at home. So now I have three of these adorable little mason jars. They are so fabulous. And I think what I'm going to do with these is I'm either going to use them for some of my own personal herbs for storage, or I might even use them for gifts. I have all kinds of ideas in mind. I like to use a lot of natural elements when I decorate jars and things like that when I give them as gifts. So I might do that if I'm doing something special, maybe a special potpourri blend for someone as a gift. Because like I said earlier, I am thinking Christmas, people. I'm thinking holiday time. Not only Christmas, but Yule and just the holidays. It's just amazing. Even Samhain. Oh my gosh. I could create something perfect, a little magical concoction inside here for Samhain. Oh my god, maybe even moon water. The possibilities are so endless. I'm so excited. And yeah, so I'm going to use these for something special for the holiday time. With Samhain being the closeout on the wheel of the year, it could be totally amazing. And then Yule actually is the beginning of the Wheel of the Year, for those of you that celebrate all the Sabbats on the Wheel of the Year. So there's so many things coming up. And then for the regular calendar year, Christmas and New Year's. Christmas marks the end of the year, and then New Year's marks the beginning. So there's so many ideas that could go into this. But yeah, Samhain could be a beautiful time to create some magical potpourri blend in these jars. Oh my goodness. Yeah. Or even as a Yule gift. I keep repeating myself, but I'm just so excited. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. I had such a grand time yesterday at the Antique Emporium. And with my friend Kathy, we closed out the day with a beautiful dinner. Jimmy joined us at her home, and we had food and friendship, and it was totally a very beautiful, special, and magical day and evening. So, thank you for watching. Thank you for being here with me and watching my videos. I love all of your support. It really means so much to me that you hang out with me and enjoy your time watching, and I hope you're being inspired. I hope you're having a wonderful and magical day, and I'm sending you many, many blessings of friendship and love and beauty and friendship always to come. Many blessings, everyone.